Let's tell you what's happened in the Supreme Court today and the horrifying nature of the Lakhimpur Kheri violence. The Supreme Court has taken sumo to cognizance of that incident here. 5 days on with the UP police investigating, with an SIT being set up here as well, but there have still not been made a single arrest. This is pertaining to 8 fatalities that were reported that day. So taking sumo to cognizance of these killings here, the Supreme Court takes up this issue, demanding to know how many arrests have been made so far. Apex Court asking the UP government here to file a status report by tomorrow itself, seeking details on who are the accused that are named in their FIRs. Remember, there are only 2 FIRs in this case right now. And what action has been taken? A lawyer who had written to the Chief Justice of India on this issue, drawing the court's attention to this incident. This lawyer had accused the UP government of not carrying out investigations properly. Meenakshi Bhanja is getting us further details here. Meenakshi, we once again looking at the UP police, the UP government being taken to task on a horrifying crime that has taken place in their state.
Well, that's right. And that is the reason just ahead of the hearing today, we saw the setting up of this inquiry commission by the UP government with a notification and a 2-month deadline for them to complete the inquiry. And undoubtedly, when the matter came up for hearing, the Honorable Chief Justice of India questioned the counsel for UP government, saying that the one of the primary allegations against the state of UP is that they're not conducting investigations in a proper manner. To which then the council informed the Supreme Court about the setting up of this inquiry commission and also the registration of various FIRs, which the Supreme Court has now sought a status report on. We will be seeing further deliberations on the matter tomorrow, when the state of UP will be formally coming out with the entire status of the investigations conducted into this incident yesterday. After the Supreme Court taking stock of the matter yesterday. So the Supreme Court also clarifying that there was some miscommunication on the part of the registry to have this matter listed as a suo motu case, while in fact the Supreme Court is reacting to a letter that was written by UP-based lawyers to the Chief Justice of India.
Right, so the Supreme Court responding to that letter here as well. Meenakshi Bhanja, many thanks for getting us those updates. But talking about probe details, let's get you whatever little update that has taken place on these cases here. But this is the latest. The Uttar Pradesh police has now formed a district level inquiry committee to probe into the killings here. The inquiry committee is to be led by the UP police and will conduct a spot test now every day. On the other end, the UP government has also announced that there is going to be a judicial probe panel that is to be headed by a retired High Court judge to investigate the killings. Now, the single-member commission of inquiry that will be headed by the retired Allahabad High Court Judge Pradeep Kumar Srivastava, which will be headquartered in Lakhimpur Kheri. The commission has also been asked now to complete the inquiry within a period of 2 months' time that has been given to this now. But the Congress and the Samajwadi Party are demanding more. They're saying that they have opposed this move here as well. They have said that it shouldn't have a retired judge. It should be headed by a sitting High Court judge to monitor this probe.
सरकार द्वारा एक न्यायिक जांच आयोग का जस्टिस श्रीवास्तव जो बहुत ही सीनियर रिटायर्ड हाईकोर्ट के जज हैं उनके नेतृत्व में एक आयोग का गठन कर दिया गया है। आज जितने भी आरोपी साक्षियों से पाए जा रहे हैं सभी के खिलाफ हम जल्द से जल्द कार्रवाई सुनिश्चित कराएंगे। कानून सबके लिए समान होता है। यदि हम साक्ष्य पा रहे हैं, तकनीकी परीक्षण करा रहे हैं, तो कानून सबके लिए समान है और किसी भी दोषी को बख्शा नहीं जाएगा।
मेरे नज़रिए में और परिवारों के नज़रिए में भी रिटायर्ड जज नहीं, एक सिटिंग जज सुप्रीम कोर्ट या हाई कोर्ट के इनके अंडर जांच होनी चाहिए। सबसे पहली बात ये। दूसरा, मैं जांच पे टिप्पणी नहीं करना चाहती क्योंकि जांच शुरू ही नहीं हुई है, लेकिन मैं इतना कह सकती हूँ कि अगर जांच निष्पक्ष होनी है तो उस मंत्री को इस्तीफा देना पड़ेगा। हम सब परिवारों के साथ मिले कल, तीनों परिवारों ने एक ही चीज़ की कही, हमें मुआवजा से कोई मतलब नहीं है, हमें न्याय चाहिए, मंत्री को बर्खास्त करना चाहिए और जिसने ये किया है, जो भी अपराधी है, उसको गिरफ्तार करना चाहिए।
लॉ एंड ऑर्डर पर ये सरकार पूरी तरीके से फेल हुई है। सरकार के रहते हुए न्याय नहीं मिलेगा, इसीलिए सिटिंग जज के मॉनिटरिंग में ये जांच हो तो परिवारों को न्याय मिलेगा। यहाँ भी जो नामजद हैं वो गृह राज्य मंत्री के परिवार के बेटे हैं, तो क्या उम्मीद करते हो सरकार न्याय करेगी इन पर? बीजेपी की सरकार है, बीजेपी से न्याय पाना ये उम्मीद करना आपको छोड़ना पड़ेगा। भारतीय जनता पार्टी अपनी मन मर्जी से काम करती है।
Meanwhile, the second post-mortem report now is out as well of one particular farmer who sustained fatal injuries here, and the family was alleging that he had bullet wounds here. But according to the preliminary report, the victim had died because of hemorrhage and that there was no bullet injury that was found. There were multiple injury marks here that were mostly because the body was dragged that have been found on the victim's body. We should remember the second post-mortem also was done after the family suspected the farmer died because of bullet injury.
As far as the investigation is concerned, SIT is investigating the matter. However, on the other hand, Uttar Pradesh government has also set up the commission. This commission will inquire the whole matter, in which it will also ascertain whether it was a negligence on the part of the police or not at the time of the incident, and other angles as well. But in the investigation, yes, the SIT investigation will ascertain exactly what all had happened at that day. And in fact, who are the culprits due to which 8 persons lost their lives. So as far as this investigation is concerned, nothing much has been done so far. In fact, SIT is only collecting the video so far, and in fact they have requested the people, those who are witness or those who are having any kind of evidences related to the case, they should come forward and give and submit the proof to the police first. The second is that the police is also taking the statements and recording the statements of the witnesses, but they have not got any kind of help so far to establish that who are the main culprits. Remember, 5 days have already happened, but no arrests happened so far into this case. As far as yesterday's post-mortem examination is concerned, yes, Gurvinder Singh, who was 19 year old, he was the farmer. His family members were not satisfied with the post-mortem examination report that came on his body, which says that he died because of the hemorrhage and also because of multiple injuries on his body. Family members had said that he died because of the bullet injury, and those who were in the convoy of the BJP leader, they were opening fire. But in the second post-mortem, which was conducted yesterday, nothing this kind of thing has come out in the postmortem examination report that he died of bullet injury, or there is, and in fact in the postmortem report there is no bullet injury found in his body.